You can do it.
20 seconds!
She's not gonna make it, is she?
Santa, it's okay to let her go.
Why do I bother, Claus?
Stop looking at that list.
No one believes in me anymore.
Three.
Melody.
Two.
Please.
Hold on. I want to tell you this the way it was told to me, from when I was a little boy. This is the story of one remarkable Christmas Eve, many, many years ago, when the most hopeful person loses hope. To really get at the heart of what happened that fateful night, you'll need to put your feet in the shoes of a little kid. And a little kid who was begging Santa to forgive them for anything that might have put them on the naughty list.
I didn't mean to lie. I just got confused.
I'm on the naughty list, but let me tell you what actually happened.
Whatever the case may be, kids are hoping to be forgiven, hoping for redemption. Now, how do you get on the good list? Truth and kindness. It's really that simple. If you're both truthful and kind, your name will disappear from the naughty list and magically appear on the good list.
Ho, 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 there with you. Gotta get a ho, 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 hold of your loving face. It's the time for dreams are coming true. It's the time I'm dreaming of you.
Can you hear me, Santa?
That is the star of our story, Melody Sanchez. Melody was born in a small, forgotten coal town. She was a beacon of light to her parents. But poverty had taken over and they couldn't make ends meet. Melody's parents constantly argued and never saw eye to eye. And on Christmas Eve, when Melody was 3 years old, her mom walked out of their lives forever.
For the holidays, but no more.
Melody was raised by her dad, who always made sure that she was loved and cared for. He never spoke poorly of Melody's mom, and he hid his pain by smiling a lot and making jokes. Melody acted like it didn't affect her. And as she got older, she got tougher. Never shared her emotions and just pretended that her mom not being around didn't bother her. And every Christmas Eve, including this one, Melody tries to talk to Santa, pleading like all the other kids do.
All the other 11-year-olds get their toys and stuff. Why not me? Am I that bad? If you are out there, this Christmas, I want...
Oh, we'll return to Melody. Now, let's get back to the North Pole, minutes before Santa's liftoff. It's cold out there, windy, and snow is blanketing every inch of the workshop, the dorms, everything. The elves run around in a panic, some putting the final touches on decorations, some clearing the snowy roads, some serving hot cocoa. Meanwhile, at the landing strip, the team is in the final stages before liftoff. The reindeer get their final adjustments. And Santa climbs aboard the sleigh. And like clockwork, Mrs. Claus hands Santa his famous red hat, which he always forgets.
Thanks, Claus.
I would never let you go without your Santa cap. You know that, Nick.
We are near the two-minute warning! Two-minute warning, my fellow elves!
That is Janaya, Santa's chief of staff, so to speak. Hardworking, disciplined, and the stage manager of this whole operation. Christmas doesn't happen without Janaya. She's talking to a bunch of department heads, her executive staff, having their final production meeting. Well, kinda.
Don't look at me. I don't know what to get him.
We should just get him a fruitcake.
Snow globe.
I
love fruitcake.
He likes it. This is stressful.
What do you get the person who has everything? Which I really haven't spoken much about our fearless leader, Santa. Santa is a good person. He believes in working hard, loves kids, and loves to help. He also gets tired sometimes, and frustrated, and sad. And right before liftoff, with all of this commotion and hubbub around him, Santa is holding with his outstretched hands the naughty list. One name in particular, Melody Sanchez.
Come on, Melody.
Okay.
When that telephone rings from Central Headquarters, every single being on the North Pole silences themselves. Janaya's elf steps.
This is Janaya. Copy.
Janaya looks at her official pocket watch.
And we are synced. My fellow elves, we are a go for launch.
Oh my gosh, yes, okay, you're right.
364 days of meetings and plans and preparation comes down to this moment. This is what they've all been waiting for. The elves are readying themselves for launch, including Janaya's team.
All right, no time to lose. Let's start with jewels. What do we need to know about P&G?
Presents and gifts are A100. We've even dropped in a few extras in there, just in case anything changes with the naughty list.
Shh! Okay, let's not make this any bigger than it needs to be, Jer.
Sorry, I'm nervous.
Keep breathing, Jer. Jackie, how's weather?
There is a rainstorm in Western Africa, and that will make Santa's travel slightly difficult. My concern is the eastern seaboard of North America, from Nova Scotia all the way to North Carolina, and as far west as West Virginia, but we're keeping an eye on it.
Whew, thanks, Jax. Jer, human resources.
Yes, the lists are clean. Address maintenance was good. This year we inputted the coordinates and checked them twice. The good list is very ready.
And the naughty list, Jer?
I don't know, this isn't the easiest topic. There was a lot of turmoil on the planet this past year. It was very hard for so many people and their families, and...
Jer, dear, you can just say it. It's okay. You got some data, and I have a feeling the analysis isn't good. Am I right, son?
The statistics say that there are more children's names on the naughty list than ever before. Well, since we've been recording this type of information.
I see. And how many of the naughty list has turned into non-believers?
Nearly 65%.
It's been a hard year.
You're right about that. Let's keep going. Janaya, continue on.
All right. So let's start with our reindeer, who could be here because...
You okay, Chris?
I'm fine. I'm fine.
I can tell. You're doing perfect.
I'm trying to listen, Claus.
How can you listen when you're glued to that list?
I'm multitasking.
Oh, I see. Multitasking.
Mm-hmm. We didn't get glitter this year?
Right. Oh, yeah.
Reindeer are healthy, like I said. Last and definitely not least, how's mechanics? How's our sleigh doing, Justin?
Oh, it's no mere sleigh. I've upgraded it with walkie-talkie ability.
It's incredible. I've been playing with it. How's safety with regards to our sleigh?
Okay, so she's in perfect working order. Everything's working great. Just be careful on hard right turns.
Santa, did you hear that?
Honey, they're talking to you.
Melody's name is still on naughty, Claus. She's got time to get her name off this thing.
20 seconds!
Melody, truth and kindness. That's all you need.
Chris, it's almost time.
Why do I bother, Claus?
Because we need you. We all need you.
Melody.
Two.
Please.
One. Christmas, go!
For the first time in history, Christmas was delayed. Santa didn't lift off.
Santa Claus, you have to go. Every second counts.
I don't know. I'm not supposed to know how to solve this.
What's the
Somebody
holdup?
Hand me my ring.
Nick, talk to me.
Melody, stop believing.
It's a hard world now. She and her father have been through so much. Her mother's... It's not your fault.
I don't know. I just don't know.
We can talk about this later. You need to go.
Santa, we really need liftoff.
St. Nicholas, I'm not gonna say it again.
I'm sorry. You're right, Claus. I'm sorry. I'll be back soon. Go, Rudolph! Go!
The moon shines a path for them as they rocket through the Arctic skies.
High all over the town, but Santa's on his way to the moon. Santa's on his way to the moon.
You really want to know who Santa Claus is? You have to watch him doing his job. He was born for this. His agility, his speed, his inability to be detected. Over cities, towns, farms, islands, deserts, winter, summer, apartments, poor, rich, nothing stops this man from his work. Like I said, he was put on Earth for this.
Santa's on his way to the ground.
Right before the last leg of a very long day. Huge thunderstorm in the middle of winter, if you can believe that. I guess this is kind of where the story begins.
Rudolph! I'm following your light. Let's watch the turns.
The air is thick, and there's only an hour, maybe an hour and a half, of deliveries left to make.
Push ahead, we're close to finishing.
He's working hard, concentrating, eyes laser focused on success. And then, well, a sudden chill goes down Santa's spine. Santa peeks his head over the sleigh, looking down towards the lands beneath him.
Santa, this is Janiyah. Over. Seems like we're slowing down. Can I get a copy? Over.
Santa didn't even hear that. He knows exactly where he is. And it doesn't take him long to change his plan.
Turn right!
Do not turn right.
Yep.
Over.
You guessed it.
Let's go right!
About 10 miles out of town, one lady witnessed the whole thing. She got out of her car with sudden worry on her face as she watched a peculiar light fall towards the main town. A sole witness.
Santa, this is Janiyah. Can you hear me? Santa, over.
I hear you. I'm okay. Vixen, Comet, how are you? Oh, good, 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 good.
What happened, over?
I thought I changed directions because I was... Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, everyone okay? That's all that really matters. Janiyah, tell me the procedure.
Copy. Let's go with the third playbook. Let me get all of us organized on our end, and we'll give you clear instructions. Over.
I don't know.
And now the howls and rain of the forests get Santa to thinking.
Rudolph. Maybe I should stop. Why am I bothering with all this?
Rudolph's red nose loses a little of its glimmer at Santa's question.
Santa, we are ready to implement the playbook.
Janiyah, I think I'm done.
Come again?
If I can't even help the children that need it most, then it's time to give it a rest. You heard Jerry earlier. You heard the statistics. And I'm tired. Selfishly, I'm tired. The world is hard now. We feel alone. Even the simple notion of truth and kindness is too much for anyone. Oh, don't look at me like that, Vixen. You know I'm speaking truth. I just can't anymore. I quit.
Santa, we're so close to finishing tonight.
Santa Claus quit that Christmas Eve. Santa walks down the hill, down a little path, never once looking back. When he gets to Main Street, he walks directly towards a brightly lit Jake's Barroom. Santa walks in.
Jake? You here?
The bar is emptier than usual tonight, which isn't saying much. Some Christmas decors are up as a jukebox plays lightly in the back. One gentleman slouches at a corner table, intoxicated. Santa saddles up to the bar, waiting for the bartender.
Jake, you back there?
There's an old bedsheet turned into a curtain that separates Jake's bar room from Jake's home.
Sorry. Didn't know anyone was here besides Charlie over there, and he's been knocked out cold for hours.
Poor Charlie. He wanted a doctor's kit one Christmas, but we couldn't deliver it to him because he had a hard time telling the truth.
Yeah, old habits die hard. Yeah, sure. What can I get you, Santa?
Can I get a Bloody Mary? Make it a virgin.
This is my bar room, Santa. I can get you whatever you need.
Thank you, son.
With very little energy, Santa takes off his red cap and plops it on the bar counter.
Tough day?
It's Christmas Eve. It's raining outside, and I just quit.
Ooh, tough day. Well, with the world the way it is, I get it.
Oh, I get it. Trust me, Jake, I get it.
Let me work on that drink.
Oh, I don't know.
Are you supposed to be Santa Claus?
Melody Sanchez and Santa Claus. Face to face.
There you are.
Here I am.
You've been on my mind, partner.
Oh, yeah? Does that mean you're gonna get me my gift this year?
You tell me.
Mister, I'm not into your games.
Oh, you met my daughter, Melody. Mel, be good, please. This is Santa Claus.
There's no Santa Claus. Give me a break.
He's sitting right in front of you. It's the stuff of Christmas miracles.
Why do you think I'm here?
See? Gonna go get some ice out back, Santa.
Why are you here?
For you.
Why, for me? And don't say to give me a gift. I'm way too old for that.
I don't have your gift.
I knew it.
I'm sorry.
So, you're not going to get me what I want for Christmas?
I just quit, Melody. I'm out of the game.
See, that just means you just lied to a bunch of kids just like me. The real Santa doesn't give up. In conclusion, I don't believe in you.
I believe in you.
Why? Why? My dad and I live in the back of a bar, Chief, and my mom left me. Now I'm looking at you in your red suit, a suit that your wife probably made for you.
My wife did make this suit.
Psh! Give it a rest,
Virgin
mister.
Virgin Bloody Mary for Santa Claus himself.
Thank you, young Jake. But I should get going.
Mel, what did you say to him?
I didn't do anything wrong, Dad.
Melody's telling the truth.
Okay. Well, bed soon. Presents tomorrow.
I'm sleeping in.
And with that, Melody leaves.
Sorry about Melody.
I do not apologize. I'm the one that didn't get her what she asked for.
She told you about that?
I know all about it. She hasn't had a fair shake. Neither of you did. Just keep telling her about truth and kindness. Can you do that for me, son?
I'm trying, Santa. I'm trying.
I know you are. Son, I need to make a telephone call. Do you mind?
Only working phone is the payphone in the back.
I hate to ask, but I don't have a wallet.
Coins in a little bowl at the bottom.
Really?
If you're at the barroom on Christmas Eve, the least I can do is pay for your phone call.
You are always considerate, Jake.
Wait. Do I know you?
Of course you do. I'm Santa Claus.
Right. You calling the North Pole, Santa?
Yeah, I am.
Hello, Nick.
How did you know?
I could feel it. You going to finish tonight?
I can't. I can't do this anymore.
Honey, we all get scared. You're doing the best you can. We're all doing the best we can. And sometimes it works out, and sometimes it doesn't.
Tell that to Melody.
Tell me what?
Less than 2 feet away, Melody stands, strangling Santa's red cap in her right hand as if holding it for ransom.
Tell me what?
That my best isn't good enough.
It's not.
That I'm scared.
You're scared?
I am.
Are you scared because of me? Because I can't be fixed?
No.
Because I'm not a bad kid.
Of course you're not.
You can't be scared. Not now. Not when it's all like this. I begged for you tonight. I begged for you. I clasped my fingers. I begged because I do believe in you, Santa. And I want my mom.
I know.
I want my mama.
I know your truth.
Melody! Bedtime!
I can't believe I'm crying.
It's good to cry.
Yeah. I feel lighter. Thank you for listening.
Anytime, Melody. Anytime.
Santa?
Yes?
You left your cap on the bar, so I was wondering...
Yes?
Can I put your hat on your head?
Of course you can, my sweet.
Santa goes on one knee. Melody walks up to him. She loosens her grip on his hat. Melody places Santa's cap on his head.
There you are, Santa.
A lady walks in.
Excuse me?
Hi. Welcome. It'll be 1 second. Dad!
I'm sorry.
What are you sorry for?
Oh, my goodness.
What? Santa, what?
Melody?
Melody's eyebrows soften, her breath shortens, hair sticking up.
Do I know you?
You do.
Okay.
Did you even need to ask? You're my double.
Okay.
I'm your mom.
Oh, mama, mama, mama.
Can you look at the way?
I can't believe it. I can't.
They hold each other.
I won't let you go.
How is this possible?
I saw a shooting star, and I got worried that you might be in trouble, but I might have been imagining it. Is that Santa Claus?
Hello, Nora.
How did you know
my... Thank you. Thank you, Santa. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
No need to thank me. You did this. Your truth and your kindness
I never doubted you for a minute.
Some might say they don't believe in you. The reindeer, the sleigh, and the big red suit. But there's nothing they could say that would ever give me pause. I never doubted you for a minute. I always knew that you would bring it. I never doubted you for a minute, Santa Claus.
I wish I was right there with you.
Mrs. Claus, you still there?
Did he say Mrs. Claus?
You hear all of this, my darling?
Of course. I'm crying over here. Oh, of all things, your red cap.
She did it.
She did. And so did you. I never doubted you for a minute. I always knew that you would bring it. I never doubted you for a minute, Santa Claus. I love you, Nick.
I love you, my love.
Nora?
Hey, Jake.
What are you doing here?
For the past few years, on Christmas Eve, I park about 10 miles away, hoping to have the courage to walk in here and talk to my daughter and make amends to you, Jake.
Nora.
I'm a nurse now. I work at two local hospitals, late shift, but it's good. It's something.
What gave you the courage tonight?
I swear, I saw a shooting star, Jake, coming right into this place.
I'm pretty sure that was my sleigh.
You should get going.
When you're right, you're right. I'm just enjoying this moment. I'll see you soon, Claus. Merry Christmas!
Santa moved as fast as he could to get back to his sleigh. Once he was there, he had to address Rudolph.
I was off base, Rudolph. And I apologize to you for dimming your spirit. Janiyah, are you there? Over.
Santa! Yes!
I'm sorry, Janiyah. Sorry to all of you. Let's finish strong, shall we?
And with that, they lift off. Meanwhile, peeking out of her little window, Melody Sanchez looks up into the sky and waves.
Thank you, Santa.
In the cool calm of floating through clouds at rapid speeds, Santa's eyes began to water. A mixture of feelings, regret for giving up so quickly, or that these feelings might happen again. As wind rushed by him and the moon guided him home, I think Santa realized that he's just one man. He still has doubt, just like all of us.
I never doubted you for a minute. I always knew that you would bring it. I never doubted you for a minute, Santa Claus. Oh, Santa Claus,
oh, Santa Claus,
my Santa Claus,
my Santa Claus.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas! Nice landing, team.
Ladies and gents, that's a wrap on Christmas this year.
Hey there, Santa Claus.
I was looking for you.
I'm right here beside you.
The Rock.
You better believe it.
Santa, sorry to interrupt. It's just, Jules, go ahead.
At first, we didn't know what to get you. Well, here you are. From all of us to the man in red.
Open it up.
What did we get him? No, nobody told me.
Jules and her team have been working really hard on this.
What is it, Santa?
I think it might be a fruitcake.
Oh, my.
Do you like it?
What is it?
Melody Sanchez. On the top of this year's good list.
When the world becomes too much and I start feeling small, I picture Melody's face as she looked at her mom that Christmas Eve. Or Santa's goosebumps as he was watching them hold each other. Yeah, I think about them holding each other a lot. Melody and her mom, Nora, grew to love each other again. It didn't happen overnight, but they learned from each other. In their own ways, Nora and Jake raised Melody to become a caring and strong person. Melody studied hard, became a teacher, and then a principal. Eventually, that led to her being a superintendent, then a chancellor. And finally, Melody Sanchez, the little girl who grew up in the back of her dad's barroom, became a mayor.
You're making me blush now.
We're proud of you, Memes.
Well, I'm still just Melody.
That's true. And every Christmas, while trimming the tree, you tell us the story of that magical night. The story of truth and kindness.
Truth and kindness.
Truth and kindness.